Rouse's is proud of the creativity and the unparalleled entertainment in New Orleans, and honored to highlight it with their sponsorship of Steppin' Out on WYES.
I'm Peggy Scott Laborde, and welcome to Steppin' Out with updates from the local restaurant, arts, and entertainment scenes. Joining me, Poppy Tucker, host of Louisiana Eats on WWNO Radio. Hey, Miss Poppy. Hello there. And Jessica Harris, author, culinary historian, and TV star. Hello, Jessica. And we'll talk about the TV aspect shortly. Thank you. Ian McNulty. It's so great to see Ian again. Food writer for the Times-Picayune, the New Orleans Advocate. But here today in a slightly different capacity, as you'll hear. Hi, Ian. Hello. And
hi.
Alan Smason. Hey there. Alan Smason of TheaterCriticism.com and the Crescent City Jewish News.
Hey, Peg.
Hey. Poppy, what began as a pop-up has really blossomed, hasn't it?
It is so nice to see people make that transition from pop-up to bricks and mortar. And I'm so happy for Budsy, because Budsy's authentic Thai is the real thing. And I would venture to say some of the best Thai food that you can find anywhere, except Thailand, I guess. What they mean by authentic is that these are old recipes that have been passed down in her family and not written down. That's the green chicken curry, and of course there's a fabulous red curry too. And if you're a noodle lover like me, you can go crazy. There's the pad see, which is a fat noodle stir fry. There's also incredible drunken noodles, and it was very, very delicious to chew on some grilled pork shoulder. This is a fabulous dish with spicy sam tam papaya salad, and then her waterfall pork. It's gorgeous. But she's doing things. There you see those drunken noodles. It's the curly ones. She's got things that I haven't seen anyplace else. She has a house-made Isin sausage that is basically like a Thai boudin sausage. It's got rice and glass noodles in it. They're open down in the Marigny Tuesday through Sunday, serving continuously from 11 a.m. through 9 p.m. and 10 p.m. extended till on the weekends. It's a really cool place. You've got a great mix of people. It's just like the heart of the Marigny.
All right. Thank you so much, Ms. Poppy. And moving over to Jessica, who is coming to us from Brooklyn, we should point out, even though she's also very much of a New Orleanian. Jessica, congratulations. There's so much to congratulate you for. But first of all, a new Netflix series, one of my favorite of your 12 books, hard to choose, but is High on the Hog. And of course, this is how African-American cuisine transformed America. So you had this book and producers came to you and said?
they said, we want to option it. I had no idea what that meant. Nothing else of mine had ever been even discussed for option. And, you know, I sort of said, well, yeah, sure. Why not? And it was Fabian Toback and Karis Jagger, and they just were war horses. They stood their ground, fought for everything, got it to Netflix, got it produced, and it's coming out. It's debuting on the 26th. I'm thrilled.
And it's 4 1-hours, and it's hosted. You are, of course, in the first episode, and of course inspire the whole series. But a young man named Steven Satterfield, what a chef and food writer. Is that among his background?
Or? Chef, well, he's worked as a chef, but he's also a sommelier. He's just got an incredible palate. He publishes a magazine called Whetstone that some of your viewers are probably familiar with. And he is the host, so he takes the viewers on a journey.
He has a lot of charisma, very handsome. So now, though, let's have a scene. Here's a scene from the first episode of High on the Hog in Benin, Africa.
I just feel like, you know, the experience of seeing my own likeness.
Isn't it?
Reflected.
Isn't it?
In the hair. I see our style and the garments and how we wear stuff.
And in our swagger?
Our swagger, our ingenuity, our resourcefulness. I mean, obviously it's enormous, but there does seem to be some kind of order.
Oh no, there's absolutely order.
Yeah.
And the thing that's interesting is just seeing how many different things are actually sold.
Right.
And once again, yes, May the 26th. Jessica, that is in Benin, Africa, part of West Africa?
Benin is in between Togo and Nigeria. It is right there. It is the part of West Africa that used to be known as the Slave Coast. So you get a sense of the history and of the connections. And interestingly enough, in Gwendolyn Midloe Hall's book, where she talks about the original Africans who were enslaved in New Orleans, they came from Senegambia and they came from Benin. So there are definite New Orleans connections.
Yes. Well, throughout the series, though, you show how foods like okra and rice are so important to the overall history of the African-American contribution, you know, to America's cuisine. And I, for the umpteenth time, tell us what the African equivalent of the word okra is.
Oh, well, it's French. It's not necessarily African. The African would come from Ghana, which is a different country. But in French, to learn a French word that is at the same time an English word, if you want okra, you simply ask for gombo.
That kind of does it all, doesn't it?
That sums it up.
And just to be in West Africa, that must have been quite an experience. I know you've been there before, of course, many times, but that must have been quite an experience. What you see in that first episode is how emotional Stephen gets, you know, to revisit this. That was really quite powerful.
Right. Well, it was his first time to the continent, and so it was his first trip to some very kind of heavy places, but heavy places that need to be visited and need to be honored. So he acquitted himself brilliantly, and you know, I'm not going to spoil it for folks, right, but it does provide a moment.
And of course, then later in the episodes, Charleston, Texas, I mean, they're all over the place, but I'm sure you've got to be real excited to see this.
Oh my goodness, I am just thrilled. I am absolutely thrilled. And, you know, Fabienne and Karis found some people that I had not heard of. They're going to be people who are familiar and people who are like, what? There are people doing that? They're going to be all kinds of things. So it's an adventure.
Congratulations.
It's an adventure.
We're going to come back to you because you have a brand new book. So we'll see you shortly. Thank you so much, though. And Ian,
thank you. Normally
we talk about food, but we have you, at least in the first segment, in a different capacity. Oh, all right. Tell us about this.
Well, Peggy, there's always a food angle, and we will get into that a little later in the show. But today I'm here to talk about NOLA Gold Rugby. This is the newest professional sports team in New Orleans that's playing this season in a spot that's very familiar to New Orleans people. Some will remember it as Zephyr Field. Some will remember it as Baby Cake Stadium. The Shrine on Airline is perhaps a familiar name. Well, now it's the Gold Mine on Airline. The old baseball field has been transformed into a rugby stadium. And the NOLA Gold, they play in Major League Rugby. This is a growing professional league all across the country and in Canada that has been playing for 4 years. New Orleans is one of the inaugural teams, one of the first teams of this growing league. And they've been part of it from the start, and they are in the midst of their season, and they've got a great game coming up this Saturday at the Gold Mine on Airline when they face the Utah Warriors, who are visiting. And the reason I'm talking about them today is I have a role on the team in the broadcast booth. I'm the play-by-play commentator. for the games when they go out over Cox Sports Television and broadcast really anywhere on streaming through the rugbynetwork.com. But Peggy, this has been like a really, just really, really great experience to be part of, because like a lot of things, you know, it starts small, kind of grassroots, and through the seasons, we've been seeing it develop, seeing the league grow, seeing the team grow, and the level of athlete that's being drawn to NOLA Gold, to this major league team in our backyard, is through the roof. We're talking about people who have played in the World Cup for their home countries in rugby-loving countries around the world: South Africa, New Zealand, Australia, Chile, Argentina, and here in New Orleans. We've got graduates from Tulane University and Shaw High School playing on the same squad with all these guys. It's really, really fun. If people haven't seen rugby before, it's the sport that led to American football.
And you have played, so you know it. You have played.
Oh, yes. Yes, I've played for years. And that's, you know, like a lot of grassroots things. You know, this team was started by a local guy. He recruits his local friends. Who do I know who does any broadcasting? Ian. Okay, put him in the booth. So that's how it started.
And Ian, for Cox Orleans, what channel is that? What channel is Cox Orleans?
Cox Sports Television. Locally, that's going to be on channel 37. The game airs at 9 o'clock on Saturday there, but you can kind of anytime you want on therugbynetwork.com.
Okay. Great. Thank you so much. And moving back over to Alan.
Well, Peggy, if there's ever any indication that we are perhaps out of that pandemic that we've been dealing with for the past year and getting back to what we call normal, it's the production that's going on right now at Rivertown Theaters of Performing Arts, because there you'll hear boisterous laughter. You'll see the seats filled to capacity as they present Grease. And what a wonderful way to mark a return to the theater. It's a show that's had staying power since it started in Chicago in 1971, triumphed on Broadway many times, and left a lasting impression from the movie that was made in 1978. Four of the more well-known songs from that movie, of course, Grease, Hopelessly Devoted to You, Sandy, and You're the One That I Want, were actually just for the movie, but they're now part of the repertoire. And Kelly Fushi's the director here of Grease. No doubt this Grease would really be about the choreography. She's got a wonderful choreographer as well. Dance moves accompanied by powerful, harmonious singing, and Fushi really does not disappoint as she's cast 17 name roles and another 12 in the ensemble. Cannon Jewel is Danny Zuko. Ariana D'Antonio as Sandy Dombrowski lead the cast, and it's really delightful. There's Mark Fushi in his role as Teen Angel, Garen Mesa as Kaniki, and all of the pink ladies were fantastic standouts, as Frenchie Lauren McMahon was wonderful. But song after song, from Grease to Shake It at the High School Hop to the Yawn I Want, and the finale, We Go Together. It's a wonderful experience. There's dancing and singing to make anyone yearn for, dare I say, moon for, the simplicity of the 50s, a time when social media and parties, political parties, that is, were never in any teenager's vocabulary. Grease plays through this weekend at the Rivertown Theaters of Performing Arts. Try to get some seats. Many, many, many are gone, and there are only a few remaining. Now, early in the month, we sadly lost Michael Martin, who, of course, was known for his verboten productions, his monologues, and, of course, in several different productions, most recently seen in Le Petit's production of Noises Off before the pandemic. It's been announced that there'll be a celebration of Michael's life at the Always Lounge and Cabaret on June the 2nd at 7 p.m. It's free to enter, but donations will be welcome. And Peggy, I wanted to remind everybody about the New Orleans Opera. We talked about their upcoming season. Well, they're going to have two more performances. The first is going to happen in their backyard, as it were, at the Opera Guild home on Britannia Street. It's $30 per pod. That is, if you're in one or two people, you're a pod, or three people, whatever it is. And it's $30 per pod. And then there'll be a free presentation of their next group, which is Opera Nouvelle, which will be at the Sidney and Walda Bestoff Sculpture Garden. This is an earlier performance that you can see. It's all socially distanced still, but you can bring your chairs, bring your bug spray, and have a little bit of opera.
Okay, thank you so much, Alan. And back to Poppy. You've traveled over to Lakeview, my dear.
Yes, but we're staying in Asia with our cuisine this week. And one of my favorite, well, I think my favorite new sushi restaurant is right there on West Harrison. It's Lotus Bistro. Betty's son opened up basically during the pandemic, and she has a teeny, teeny little restaurant. There's only seven seats inside, and so her outside has really been her restaurant. And there you have a shot from where you sit at tables, and they bring out some of the most exquisite Japanese food I have eaten in quite some time. That is the lotus seafood salad. It's got cucumber noodles along with the tuna and salmon and yellowtail. Now, everybody has crispy Brussels sprouts, but hers are the best, I think, because it's really just like the leaves. So they're crispy in a sweet and savory sauce with spicy mayo and her shishito peppers, the spicy edamame. Oh, my goodness. Now, this is a special roll that really shows off her sense of humor. This is Pablo Escalar. And what I loved about it is it has eggplant. And I'm not used to having eggplant in sushi rolls, and I'm an eggplant lover. And hamachi kama, she does that too, a grilled yellowtail collar. And here's the tamago, which is a very special Japanese omelet. And they make it themselves there. It's beautiful. They're open Wednesday through Sunday. Lunch is 11:30 to 2:30, and then they close until 4:30 when they're open until 9 for dinner. And you might want to take note that Betty's catering that she's doing out of the Lotus Bistro is extraordinary. So you want to have a fabulous party, call Lotus Bistro.
That West Harrison, that stretch of Harrison, really, yeah. Culinarily, whoo, it's on the rise.
Absolutely.
Huh? Thank you so much.
Thanks,
and
Peg.
Back over to Jessica. Congratulations. Vintage postcards from the African world. And I did not know until recently that you are quite the postcard fan. A deltaologist, is that what we call that, Jessica?
Deltaologist, yep. I think that's the word. I'm never sure of the pronunciation, but deltaologist. I have been collecting postcards for, at this point, decades. And they are just, you know, it's something I do. I'm always rummaging around in used bookstores and how not to see them. And so every time I see them, I pick them up, and they tell you so much about things. This one is a religious procession in Dakar, Senegal. So you can see certainly the priest and all of the little altar boys. But if you look on the sides, you can see that the women are dressed in traditional Senegalese clothing. And this is the turn of the 20th century. So this is in the early 1900s. Mm-hmm. There are so many. This is a market woman in Barbados. And what I love about her is that tray. That tray you find all over the African Atlantic world, particularly on this side of the Atlantic. And it's probably the same tray that some of those New Orleans pralinières sold their pralines from.
Absolutely. This is amazing.
Well, we talk about Mardi Gras Indians. These are Mardi Gras Indians. They are natives of Trinidad. And there's a whole African Atlantic tradition of masquerading as Indians. So these were Trinidadian Indians. And this is a fairly early postcard. It's polychrome because it's hand-tinted. But it, again, is probably the early 1900s. Mm.
You've got New Orleans.
And that's familiar. That's the market. We know our market. We love our market. And I couldn't have any postcard book out without some of New Orleans in it. So this is the market.
Yeah. And this.
And the praline seller. She has a basket. She doesn't have that tray, but she has some of the same things that the Barbados market woman would have. She's got a fan and, of course, an umbrella to keep the sun off.
Gee. And, you have so many wonderful books, so I felt compelled that we have to give your website there, too. But congratulations.
My website.
Yeah. Go ahead. Do we have that correct?
No, I was getting ready to say. Up for an update, but yes. Yeah. Come back and check us out.
Sure. And University of Mississippi Press, congratulations.
Absolutely.
It's beautifully done.
The first book in the series.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Which is great. Thank you. And we'll come back to you for a pick of the week, but back over to Ian to talk about something from a culinary standpoint and still connected to your favorite sport.
Well, yes, this Saturday at the Gold Mine on Airline, the baseball stadium now turned into a rugby stadium, there's going to be a preview for Hogs of the Cause. Of course, tailgating is a big part of sporting events, right? Where they're calling this a pig tailgate.
That's
so 10 teams or so from Hogs for the Cause will be on hand for this. Now, Hogs for the Cause itself is back the weekend of June 4th and 5th in Belle Chasse, just over the parish line there. But a bunch of the teams are getting together. They're going to raise money. They're going to cook a lot of great barbecue dishes, and they're going to have a tailgate party before the NOLA Gold rugby game. It's free to get in with your ticket to the game. You can go around to the different tables and booths, see what they're cooking up, sample things, vote on your favorite. And it's part of a really big day out there, Peggy, for the NOLA Gold, because a lot of people will remember the fireworks at the old Zephyrs games. Well, those are back. So at the end of the NOLA Gold game, there's going to be fireworks over the stadium once again. It's Military Appreciation Week out there, so there's going to be some special honors to service members across different armed services. And it's just a great time to get out there on a Saturday. The rain hopefully will be done with by then. We'll have the sunshine out, unaccustomed sun. A lot of smoke coming out of the smokers. Good chance to get warmed up for Hogs for the Cause, which is what those teams are doing. Have a party, get to know some of the people out there, see the gear that all the rugby people bring out. A real kind of international sporting event in your own backyard in New Orleans, but with local flavor from Hogs to the Cause, and of course the local flavor that New Orleans people bring to all the stuff they do. So I think it's going to be a great day out there. I'm really excited for it.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Ian. And back over to Alan for some more info, theater info.
I wanted to give a local shout out first that you can go to actually in person before I go to some online opportunities for this weekend. But Art Street Productions is presenting their piece this week. And essentially it's called Solidarity. And they're basically doing a piece that we're hopefully going to, you know, show you a little bit of it. It's a ballet kind of dance, kind of performance art that they're doing. It's going to be the UNO amphitheater, which they've just reopened. Performances pay as you can, whatever you can afford to go, pay. And on top of that, I would advise everybody, bring a chair or a blanket to sit on and also some bug spray. But it'll be great. It'll be at 8 o'clock on Saturday night. Now, the latest Broadway musical, Peggy, that may be the best product to ever come out of a pandemic is the piece called Breathe. And this was actually penned by Jody Picoult and Tim Allen McDonald. They actually wrote this during the pandemic. They enlisted 5 songwriting teams to write music for it, including Zena Goldrich and Marcy Heisler, who are well known. It stars some wonderful performers on Broadway like Kelly O'Hara and Brian Stokes Mitchell, both Tony Award winners. Also husband and wife team Patty Murin of Frozen, the musical, and Colin Donnell. You've got a number of other people. Like I said, the whole cast is terrific. It's a $25 charge to see it on demand, and you can see it anytime between now and July, I believe it is. It's going to be 3 streams within a 48-hour period. So if you want to see it again and see it one more time, it's only $25. And when you figure out that, it's less than $10 a showing. Also, Peggy, we often hear about husband and wife teams, but how often do you hear about a daughter and father team? Right there you see them. Lily Cooper, who was last on Broadway as the leading actress in Tootsie, she's there seen with her father, who is, of course, Scott. Scott Cooper won the Tony Award back a few years ago with Cy Coleman's The Life as featured actor in a musical. They'll both be Seth Rudetsky's guests this week on his concert. Check it out again, $50 for the VIPers, but those of you who just want to see the performance, $25 to see it live at 2 o'clock, and then it repeats at 7 p.m.
All right, thank you so much. And now it's time for our Picks of the Week. Poppy.
Whether it's summer school or summer camp, the Sazerac House is offering some big fun this summer for grown-ups. There's Barrel to the Bottle, where you get a bottle of Sazerac rye. They have a juleps event. Cheers to Cheese, where St. James Cheese Company and rum cocktails will be paired. These events cost between $20 to $40 each, and they're going to be educational and inebriating.
Sounds good. Jessica, your pick.
Okay, well, it's a weekend for pigs, because in honor of High on the Hog, my friend Dana Hahn at Cafe Carmel on Julia Street is doing a drink called Tropical Pig. He refused to tell me what it was, but if y'all go down to Carmel on Julia Street, the Tropical Pig will be available for your consumption from Friday the 21st through Friday the 28th to celebrate High on the Hog.
Well, how nice of you to have a drink in your honor of your work. I love that.
There you go.
That's great. All right, Ian. Mm-hmm.
Well, keeping the theme going with barbecue, James Cruz is the pitmaster at Central City Barbecue, and this week he picked up a major national award at Memphis in May. This is just the gold standard for barbecue competition in the U.S., and he won best rib, and he came in second for the overall grand championship in Memphis in May. It's a huge accomplishment, and it happened from a guy right here in New Orleans. So Central City Barbecue, go say hi to Pitmaster James Cruz and congratulate him on the win and get yourself a barbecue platter.
All right, thank you. Alan.
Peggy, Dave Davis is the star of the recently released The Vigil, which is sort of a horror movie with a Jewish tint, I guess you might say. Dave will be actually on site at the Broadside coming up on Tuesday, May the 25th at 7:30. You can see the film for $5, and that's being made possible by the Jewish Federation. And then afterwards, Dave will be on site to basically answer any questions. Again, it's great to see a New Orleanian make it big in the movies. And Peggy, I'll see you at the theater.
All right. Thank you, Alan. And before my picks, a very happy anniversary, 70th anniversary, to local broadcast legends Bob and Jan Carr. They are celebrating their 70th wedding anniversary on Friday, May the 21st. So many of us have found very, very fond memories of watching them on WDSU's Second Cup and midday shows in the 1960s and 70s. They have also hosted their own radio shows, and Bob has written two books. After many years of living in the French Quarter and uptown, they are now on the North Shore and still producing TV shows for their retirement community. Congratulations. They have 4 children, 7 grandchildren, and 2 great-grandchildren. Now my picks. On Saturday from 6 to 8, the Thomas Mann Studios first in-person opening at his Gallery IO, a.k.a. the Rose Tattoo, the name of the bar that used to be at that location. That's at Napoleon and Shopatoulas. The theme is flowers, and this pen by Thomas Mann is so beautiful. It's inspired by photos he has taken over the bayous, flying over the bayous of Louisiana. Other artists are also featured. Another Broadside flea market, one of my favorite things. On Sunday, starting at 10:30 a.m., food, music by the Tropicals. That starts around noon, and plenty of local artist booths along with vintage items. I found so many cool things there. Food and drink available. You all, it is so great to be with you. And Jessica, just a few parting words. Is there a next book, or are you just trying to keep up with what you've got?
Oh, no, there's the next book. It's going to be finished by the end of July, and it's going to be in, and there's some New Orleanians in the book.
Okay, very good to hear. Thank you all so much. Great to see you once again. Ian, I know I'll see you soon. Okay. Thank you,
Poppy.
Great to see
you. Thank you, everybody.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Rouse's is proud of the creativity and the unparalleled entertainment in New Orleans, and honored to highlight it with their sponsorship of Steppin' Out on WYES.